when you're lying awake with a dismal headache and repose is tabooed by anxiety. It is hardly surprising if you're agonizing considering modern society. There are terrible dangers from horrible strangers whose every intention is criminal. There are counterfeit healers and ecstasy dealers who thrive because policing is minimal. We've got underage nookie and lads playing hooky who lurk around corners to mug us. And there's proddies and papists and robbers and rapists with tabs of Rohypnol to drug us. On the streets you take fright at the menacing sight of graffiti in French and Cyrillic. Whilst behind curtains drawn, people downloading porn are indulging in tastes pedophilic. Though the threats are tremendous, the law won't defend us, and don't even think of resistance. So before it's too late, let us all emigrate to a very much better existence. Suddenly, New Zealand doesn't seem so boring. Suddenly, New Zealand seems attractively remote. Lots of sheep and lambs and 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 the occasional goat.
So you're lying in bed and the thoughts in your head return to your present condition. A beastly fanatic plans something dramatic to send us all off to perdition. From some part of the globe comes a chap in a robe and a headdress he looks very nice in. But beneath his jalaba, this fellow may harbour a lethal container of ricin. He's so fundamental, he hasn't seen Yentl and preaches demonic polemic. He wants each infidel to descend into hell with a dose of bubonic systemic. In his safe sleeper cell, he blends in very well with his suitably quiet demeanour. While he's learning to fly, he is living close by in a bedsit above your dry cleaner. We know what we must do, for the world that we knew is vanishing like the poor dodo. There's a good life to be had away from the jihad as neighbours of Bilbo and Frodo.
Doesn't seem so boring. Suddenly New Zealand seems attractively remote. Lots of sheep and lambs and 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 the occasional goat.
You lie there wide-eyed as you try to decide which of all the world's problems is scarier. The refugee crisis, the horror of ISIS, the wars in the Middle East area. Or Erdogan who, after crushing the coup, has found a new ally in Putin. A sinister twosome, the prospect is gruesome. Who knows where they'll next put the boot in. Ukraine fairly trembles as Russia dissembles whilst massing its tanks on the border. Further east, there's unease in the South China Seas, which might add to the global disorder. Don't forget North Korea, we have no idea where its missiles are like to explode. And if Trump comes to power, it'll be our last hour. Because he'll have every nuclear code. It's unbearable knowing the far right is growing, evoking a grim déjà vu. If you're outside the norm or refuse to conform, rest assured, they'll be coming for you. Get off my piano!
I have spent years working on that accompaniment, years. Where's my applause? Thank you. Recognition of love. Well, I tell you something. I am going to New Zealand, where they appreciate sopranos.
suddenly in New Zealand.
I think I'd better go and see that she's all right.
Seems attractively remote. Lots of sheep and lambs.
It's just you and me. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know about you, but I find this a very soothing little chorus. I do. I sometimes sing it to myself when the troubles of the world get too much for me. So, why don't we sing it together? Yes. Would you like to learn it? It's really easy to go. Suddenly New Zealand doesn't seem so boring. Suddenly New Zealand seems attractively remote. Lots of you learn from the occasional goat. Okay? Come on, Edinburgh. Sing your lustiest. Suddenly New Zealand doesn't seem so boring. Suddenly New Zealand seems attractively remote. Lots of sheep and lambs and 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 the occasional goat. God, that was bloody marvellous! Well, it was all right. Bit shite, really, but never mind. I've got time to do it again. I've got a plane to catch. I'm going to New Zealand right now, so thank you very much indeed for coming, ladies and gentlemen. You've been just gorgeous.